transpedicular approach requires a trajectory that matches the medial and inferior trajectory of the pedicle. The appropriate entry point onto the vertebral body for the transpedicular approach is at a point in the upper outer quadrant of the pedicle when seen on AP fluoroscopy. The tendency for many surgeons when advancing their instrument is to land on the transverse process at a point that is too lateral for a trajectory through the pedicle. When I find an appropriate entry point, I tend to feel as though I'm slightly on the uphill side of the facet joint as I enter the bone. Once the entry point is chosen on the AP fluoroscopic image, I lightly tap with a mallet to seat the instrument into the bone. At this point, the lateral fluoroscopic image allows me to extrapolate the trajectory of the instrument. The appropriate trajectory should be through the upper half of the pedicle into the vertebral body. Keep in mind that a trajectory that is too superior will result in fracture through the superior end plate of the vertebral body. A trajectory that is too inferior results in fracture through the inferior pedicle and nerve root injury. Once I'm satisfied with the cranial caudal trajectory of my instrument, I return to the AP fluoroscopic image for a key safety feature. It's important during advancement of the jam sheet through the pedicle that the tip of your instrument remain lateral to the medial edge of the pedicle on AP fluoroscopy until it enters the posterior cortical margin of the vertebral body on lateral fluoroscopy. If at any time your instrument tip is medial to the medial edge of the pedicle before entering the vertebral body, it has breached the medial pedicle and is now in the spinal canal. If at any time the trajectory is identified to be inappropriate, the surgeon can withdraw the instrument slightly and by deflecting his hand, redirect to a more appropriate trajectory into the vertebral body. Once gaining access into the vertebral body, it may be advanced under a lateral fluoroscopic image to the center of the vertebral body for direct cement injection for vertebroplasty or for exchange over a Kirschner wire for an osteointroducer cannula for kyphoplasty.